Hey, beautiful, smart, lovely, kind people of the fractured and fragmented internet. How you doing? Disclaimer, I'm about to make a YouTube video about a YouTube video. Okay, so I had this heartbreaking, incredible thought this week. I would give up every piece of any talent that I have in order for the ability to create good music. Basically, I'm saying that I would be willing to become average, way less than average, at everything in order to become good at making music. And I think that I'd be willing to do that because even though I'm a writer and I know the undeniable power of the written word, I also know that music is basically magic. Now, we could get into a heavy debate here about how music compares to other forms of art and what the uses of those forms are, but instead I'm just gonna move forward with the general knowledge that we have all been deeply impacted by music at some point in our lives. Songs that pop up and remind you of a specific memory, songs that you select to represent a certain period of your life or a relationship, and the songs that we use to mark the significant events of human life. Graduation, weddings, funerals. Speaking of significant events, I mentioned a YouTube video earlier. That video is called Disintegration Loop 1.1, and it's by the artist William Basinski. In September of 2001, Basinski did two significant things. First, he took an old magnetic tape and transferred it to digital. And he sat on the roof of his Brooklyn apartment with friends on the evening of September 11th, 2001. Lucky for us, he recorded both of these events and later combined them into a knockout punch of emotion. The magnetic tape started disintegrating slowly as he transferred it and looped it. It sounds whole at the beginning, but slowly decays and distorts. And the video footage of the sun setting over the wreckage of New York City on that evening is something else. I'll put the link down in the comments, and I encourage you guys to check it out sometime. It's a piece of music or musical art that has that emotional magic that I mentioned earlier. It speaks deeply to me about melancholy and despair and the endings of things. But it also says something to me about recovery. Those tapes were destroyed, but in the process, the audio lives on. The World Trade Center is gone, but the footage of that night is still changing people and still speaking to people. Actually, the Disintegration Loops, the name of the album that this specific loop comes from, was recently inducted into the National September 11th Memorial and Museum because of the effect it's had on people in the last 13 years. Okay. Now that you've heard me rant, I want to hear from you. Part of the wonderfulness of human experience is that each of us have these insane emotional attachments to different songs. I want to hear yours. Post down in the comments about a song that you've emotionally invested in. And if you want, tell me why. I want to try and share those emotional attachments with you and find what music is leaving a mark in the world. Okay, that's everything for this week. Thanks for tuning in. I'll see y'all soon. Best wishes. Fragmented internet. That's music. Fragmented internet. Fragmented internet.